me lost me cookie at the disco. Me lost me cookie in the boogie music. Me lost me cookie at the disco. Me want it back. Me want it back again.
Over the past couple of weeks, you would have seen my analyses on the likes of John Cena speaking Chinese and Robert De Niro speaking Thai. But as I was sitting down watching my daily episodes of Sesame Street, I noticed something that was potentially sinister at play. Why is it that Cookie Monster speaks English the way he does? Is he a genuine, non-native speaker of English? Or is he putting on a fraudulent accent just so that he could get the gig with Sesame Street? Well, if it was good enough for John Cena and Robert De Niro, it's good enough for Cookie Monster. So I've broken out the spectrogram, and today we're going to be analyzing Cookie Monster's English to see once and for all whether or not Cookie Monster is a genuine non-native speaker of English, or he is a fraud and just putting on that accent and the way he speaks English so he could get the gig for Sesame Street. So let's listen to the voice specimen the first time round.
Hello. Today, me here in local bakery here to talk about a word. Important. Yeah, when something is important, it means whole lot to you. For instance, look over here. See, take this oatmeal cookie. It's important. It means whole lot to me. In fact, all cookies, very important to me. They mean a lot to me, but they mean much more to me tummy.
Oh, that letter H. Yeah, and that's perfect, because me so hungry. Come to Papa. I am. Hey, where cookie go? Hey, why cookie all the way up there? Oh, okay, well, that no problem. Me think of word that start with H. Hop. Yeah, that good one. That no problem. Me just think of another word. Hook will get cookie down. Ha ha.
Okay, so that was the specimen that we've taken first time round, and already I can start to smell something sinister going on. To really understand this, we have to see where Sesame Street was coming from. Now, Sesame Street started in 1969. That first clip you saw there was probably somewhere around that time, 1969, early 1970s. Now, around that time, if you would remember, well, for those people who are old enough, there were many different shows around. For example, the Thunderbirds. And in the Thunderbirds, who was the villain? It was a seemingly Asian gentleman named The Hook.
At last, the Red Arrow is destroyed. In a few short hours, the gold will be mine.
You listen to his English, and it's kind of based on an amalgam of maybe a sinister Chinese slash Japanese migrant. Perhaps this was because of the Cold War, or maybe it was a legacy because of the impressions of the sinister Japanese from the Second World War. It didn't stop there. Remember, Get Smart.
Very amusing, Mr. Smart. I suppose you can guess what they call me.
Lefty?
No, Mr. Smart. I am employed by Chaos, the International Organization of Evil. My name is The Craw.
The Craw?
Oh, not The Craw. The Craw.
Oh, yes, The Craw.
The Craw. Now, again, it's taking on this 1960s Cold War impression of the sinister, generic, evil Asian accent. Now, as we do that, let's think of then, maybe this is being based on Japanese or Chinese. Is Cookie Monster really a native speaker of Japanese or Chinese? Let's find out.
Hello. Today, me here in local bakery here.
Okay, so first of all, we have this usage of me instead of I. Now, this is used right throughout. You'll never ever hear Cookie Monster say the word I. This is something that may be common with Japanese or Chinese because there is no actual different word for I and me. Me would be the accusative form, but in Chinese we would just use the word wo, Cantonese wo, in Japanese watashi boku, but it doesn't change. So this is one common feature that we'll see native speakers of Chinese perhaps use if they're not sure of the usage of I or me. That could come into play.
We talk about a word.
Okay, we talk about a word. Now, this is where we can start to get a hint of maybe Cookie Monster is not being authentic with us. He says a word. He actually uses the correct particle. He uses a word. This is the indefinite article of word. A word, the word. Now, if Cookie Monster really spoke English that badly, I don't think he would have the correct usage of articles, whether it's definite or indefinite. Let's have another listen.
Here to talk about a word.
Okay, a word. Keep that in mind.
Important. Yeah.
Now, another thing to note, important. If he was a genuine speaker of Chinese or Japanese, he wouldn't have that aspirated T at the end. Important. Important. Did you hear that?
Important.
And you can even see here on the spectrograph, important, you can see the aspiration.
Important.
Important. You can see it puffing out here on the spectrogram. That would not happen with a genuine native speaker of Chinese or Japanese.
Yeah, when something is important, it means whole lot to you.
Okay, now notice what he just said there. I'm going to play that again.
It means whole lot to.
So already we can see this incorrect use of the third person. It means. He doesn't use the S in this form, and it always comes out as it mean. He always drops the S if we're talking about this third person. Let's have another listen.
It means whole lot to you. For instance, look over here.
Again, for instance. If he was a native speaker, I don't think he would have this consonant cluster NS, ns, for instance. That's quite difficult. So again, it's telling me that he's probably not an authentic immigrant.
Look over here. See, take this oatmeal cookie. It's important.
Okay, it's important, not it's important. He's done that dropping of the S again in the third person.
Cookie, it's important. It means whole lot to me.
Okay, it important. He has the aspiration on the important, but then he loses the aspiration on it.
It mean whole.
It mean. So important, it mean. This inconsistency, again, tells me that Cookie Monster is not being genuine with us.
Whole lot to me. In fact, all cookies. Very important.
That's very interesting. Now, given that his English is supposedly so bad, he used the plural form and that S on cookies quite clearly.
In fact, all cookies, very important to me.
Okay, all cookies, very important to me. If somebody was at that level where they're dropping the S of the third person, it important to me, but he puts it in cookies on the plural, I would question that.
They mean a lot to me.
That mean, again, he drops the S.
But they mean much more to me tummy.
Oh.
Okay, that mean much more to me tummy. Again, the possessive, my tummy. So I, me, my are all being transformed into me. That is quite a low level of English, and it's not really congruent with the rest of the English or the vocabulary that he's using. Now, this is a more recent clip.
That letter H!
Okay, first of all, we can see on the spectrogram between this and this, it's obviously an entirely different voice. So again, I think that Cookie Monster is not being genuine with us. He's not actually using the same person for the voice.
Yeah, and that's perfect, because me so.
Now notice, that perfect. He's doing an aspiration on that perfect, but he drops the S. If he really did drop the S, he would probably not have an aspirated T either, because his glottis would be closing in on that important, not that important. If you could get the T out, he could get the S out.
Yeah, and that's perfect, because me so hungry. Come to Papa!
Okay, come to Papa. Honestly, this usage of idiomatic English, I really doubt that somebody of his level of English would have that depth of knowledge to be able to use idioms like this in the right context.
Hi-yam!
And notice the hi-ya, hi-ya. This is another indicator to say that this was modeled on this maybe a Western exotic form of immigrant Japanese English.
My name is the Craw.
The Craw?
Oh, not the Craw. The Craw.
Oh, yes, the Craw.
Where Cookie go? Hey, why Cookie all the way up?
Why Cookie all the way up there? Notice that he's dropped the verb to be. Why Cookie, not why is the Cookie, and he's dropped the article. Now, we heard in the very first clip from the 1960s, he actually had correct usage of articles. He knew them already back then. Why is the definite article being dropped here? He should have said, why is the Cookie all the way up there? But he just says, why is Cookie all the way up there? Again, Cookie Monster, you're inconsistent.
Hey, where Cookie go? Hey, why Cookie all the way up there? Oh, okay, well, that no problem.
Okay, that no problem. That's not a problem, or that isn't a problem. He's using just the word not here. If he were at the level of English that he's maybe feigning to be, he probably wouldn't have even used the word not. He probably said no instead of not.
Cookie all the way up there. Oh, okay, well, that no problem. Me think of word. That start with H. Hop. Yeah, that good one. That no problem.
Again, hawk, hawk. I think this is hook. Hook, maybe Cookie Monster's an immigrant to the United States and he's trying to base it on American English.
Me just think of another word. Hook will get Cookie down. Huh?
Me just think of another word.
Again, okay, another is not the definite article, but I would think maybe me just think of other word. If he were at that low level of English, he would probably say
me just think of other word
instead of another word. He's used the correct word too correctly there.
Hop! Yeah, that good one. That no problem. Me just think of another word. Hook will get Cookie down. Huh.
Okay, and notice again, there's incongruence between his first hawk and then hook. He's obviously got the correct vowels in there. He can say them. So honestly, I think that Cookie Monster probably is not a genuine non-native speaker of English. I'm suspecting that he actually is a native speaker of English and he's feigning this faux immigrant, possibly Japanese, based on those 1960s models of the villain Asian, the villain Japanese during the Cold War. And he's probably just put that accent on just so he could get the gig with Sesame Street. I hope that these analyses have been helping you, especially for learners of other languages, because what you learn from here, the influences that you get from these foreign languages as people speak English, you can actually take those and put them back onto the foreign language. Now, I'm just concerned here that if you are using Cookie Monster as a specimen to put back into a foreign language that you're learning, you may come out speaking that language not correctly, not like the locals on the ground, because Cookie Monster seems like he's not genuinely a non-native speaker of English. He's just somebody pretending to be. So it's probably best that you don't use Cookie Monster as your model for speaking a foreign language. If you've enjoyed this analysis, don't forget to click like and subscribe. And if you're really into language and learning how to speak, not just like a tourist, but really speak the language like people speak it on the ground, scan the QR code up top, jump into our Minecraft Discord server, and if you really want to learn, join the Minecraft program. I'm Stuart J. Raj, I'll see you on the other side. Thank you.